Okay, so I want to go back to the first lecture where we talked about this intuitive idea of increasing and decreasing. And particularly, I want to talk about these specific places, and I'll get maybe a little green highlighter, where this function is where we're finding these critical values. So right here, right? This 0.39, we saw this before. It's finding this critical value. And the derivative there changes from increasing to decreasing. And we've already looked at how that happens and how it splits. Now, this particular point, this critical value, is also what we call a relative maximum. Okay. So, and the idea of this is you can see kind of in the graph that it's the top of this hill. We use the word relative to describe this idea that it might not be the very highest point in the graph, but locally, we can also hear a word called local maximum. Locally, really close by, it looks like you're on the top of a hill. Okay, so in world geography, it's not Mount Everest, it's just the hill in your local neighborhood, but still in your local neighborhood, it looks like the highest point. Does that make sense? Okay, so that's the idea. Down here, we also have a local minimum. Let me do that in green as well. Right here at 8 and 1.5. Local minimum, right? It's again not the lowest point ever. It's not the lowest point on the entire graph, possibly, but it looks like a dip in the graph where you are locally. Okay, nearby, it looks like you're at a low point. Okay? Okay, so these ideas, these points, relative maximums and minimums, we want to talk a little bit about them and how we find them again using the first derivative. Okay, so these are called in general relative extrema. It's the beginning of a study in mathematics called optimization, like finding the highest and lowest points, kind of output values. Okay, and these relative extrema are this relative maximums and relative minimums. Okay, and that is the very idea of it being kind of this low point nearby or high point nearby. And we saw here, it turns out like when I look at this number line, remember I made those number lines, and here I marked some critical value. We have this dotted line, right? And this is a critical value. And if you go back to the chart up above, you'll see that like here was positive on that side, and over here was negative. And when that happens, when I move from pot go moving up to moving down, I get kind of this idea of a relative max, right? And this moving up is where f prime is positive on this side, and this moving down is where f prime is negative. Okay? And this is when I expect to see a relative max. This is the official test, first derivative test, for finding a relative maximum. Find a critical value. See, is f prime positive on the left side and is it negative on the right side? Is it moving up and then down? And then you know it kind of reaches the top of the hill. Okay? This is the very idea. Okay? So this kind of behavior where I'm going up, reach a hill, down, that's a relative maximum. So same thing for this number line. Remember we marked over here again, I'll have a critical value. And I just want to think about what we expect to see in terms of the behavior of the derivative for a minimum. So for a minimum value, I want this thing to be dipping down, right here. So I expect it to be kind of decreasing this way, right? And increasing this way. So I expect F prime to be negative on this left side, and then F prime to be positive here. And then that leads to a relative minimum. Okay, that is in pictures, and I don't really feel like I need to write it in words. That's the test, the first derivative test for local maximums and local minimums. Okay, so I do want to make sure these relative extrema, and maybe I'll just make this note, all these relative extrema, relative max and mins, come from critical values. Again, the places where F prime is either equal to zero or F prime is undefined. One of those two places. Okay? But not all critical values have to be maxes or mins. They don't. You can have a critical value, and it's possible that your picture looks something like this. And I just want to draw this picture real quick. So here's your critical value. It's possible that on this side it's going up, and on this side it's still going up. Like F prime is positive here, and F prime is positive here. In which case, you don't get a relative max or a relative min. That's entirely allowed. It's just a critical value. Okay? Okay, so we do have to do this testing again on both sides to see if our critical values are maxes or minimums. Okay, so I want to go here and do an example problem for you guys. So find all relative extrema right here for this function, f of x is equal to x cubed minus 9x squared. Okay? So first, these steps. Find the critical values. Again, I need to find these because these are going to be the candidates for my relative maximums and minimums, right? So to find critical values, I first find the derivative, and I get 3x squared minus 18x. And then I set the critical values are where, again, I'm going to sound like a broken record, f prime is 0 or f prime is undefined, right? Over and over again. That's what I'm looking for. In this particular function, there's no place where x could be in the denominator, so there's no place where this function could be undefined. This is just a polynomial, and its domain is minus infinity to infinity, right? So, but it could be equal to 0, so let's solve for that. I think I can factor out a 3 and an x, and when I do that, I'm left with an x here, and 3 out of 18 is 6, right? So I get 3x equals 0, or x is equal to 0. I think I get something like that. Okay, x equal to 0 and x is equal to 6. Okay, so I set up this number line again, and then I have this chart. So let me set up, I want to make sure that I have enough room, so let me set it up on this next page. Okay, I'm going to set this up. 0, there's 6. You can put the numbers 1 through 5 in here, but these are my critical values. And I'm going to split this down because this is going to be part of my chart, right? Okay, there's my critical values. Okay, and the first thing, I mean, like when you create this chart, you'll find intervals where it's increasing or decreasing. I want to write out these intervals again. Okay, here it's minus infinity to 0, 0 to 6, and 6 to infinity. Those are the three intervals that I'm talking about. Remember, in these intervals of increasing, decreasing, which this chart will also give me, they're always open intervals, right, using open parentheses. Okay, now I need to test a test point or find a test point, right? I'm going to find one in each of these intervals, and I want to test the first derivative in those. Okay, so here we go. Let's say in this one, maybe I'll choose x is equal to negative 1. In here, x is equal to 1. And out here, x is equal to, let's say, 10 in there. Okay, again, those are points that you're just picking randomly. F prime of the test point. Okay, I want to go back. F prime is this 3x squared minus 18x, right? So, and you get out your calculator and I'll do it too and plug these values in. 3x squared minus 9. And I need to plug in negative 1, and I get, do you guys get 21? So f prime of negative 1 is equal to 21. Over here, f prime of 1 is equal to negative 15 and 10. F prime at 10 is equal to 120. That's what I'm doing on my calculator, right? Okay, so is it positive or negative? That's the question. Here it's positive, right? Here it's negative, and here it's positive. Okay, and in my head, like, and you can write this down, you can draw arrows. Here I'm thinking this is going up, and then on this side it's going down, right? On this side it's going down, and on this side it's going up. So when I'm talking about making local extrema here, oops, I want to do that in black. Right here I got a top point, and right here I got a bottom, like a minimum point, right? So that is the result in this case when I'm finding relative extrema, right? You can get a whole bunch of information from this chart. You can talk about, now you should be able to tell me where the function is increasing, decreasing, just from this chart. But in terms of relative extrema, which I'm looking for, I should have a relative maximum of, let's see, oh, this is the question, right? Okay, so this is happening. Relative max at x is equal to 0, right? This critical value, scroll up with me. That's 0 right here. X is equal to 0. And this one is x is equal to 6 is my minimum. Okay? Relative max is at x is equal to 0. Now, the question is, that's not the maximum output. So what's the output question? Okay? So I just need to find the output of the original function f of 0. Let me plug it in. F of 0, my original function, oh, this is x cubed minus 9x squared, so that's 0 cubed minus 9 times 0 squared equals 0. So I really have the output value, the relative max, and this is the language, of 0 at x equal to 0. But this is my y value right here. We say that the maximum value is the output value. So I want to be clear about that. This is the actual relative maximum, and this is where it's located. Okay? Okay, now I have to also do when x is equal to 6. So let me do that. And I'll go back up. I think I want to reiterate, this should be a minimum, right? At x equals 6, let me just find the output value. F at 6. Oops, I'm using the derivative, and I don't want to do that. So let me make sure f of x equal x cubed minus 9x squared. You got to be careful about what you're plugging things into. 6 cubed minus 9 times 6 squared. And let me figure out what that is. Cubed. And I get negative 108. Is that what you get? So, and the result for this, I have a relative minimum of negative 108, the output value at x is equal to 6. Okay, and the maximum too. Let me write that again, because it's up above. Max of 0 at x equal to 0. Both of those should be part of this solution. Okay? Okay, let me know if you have any questions, but that's how we find relative extrema using the first derivative test.